Hello friends, I am Aditi Vala from Department of English Maharaja Krishna Kumar Singh Ji Bhavnagar University. Happy Teachers Day all of you. In India, 5th September, we are celebrated as a Teachers Day. Today we are planning to celebrate Teachers Day, so I would like to teach a novel by J.M.Coetzee. First of all, we can throw some light on author's life. J.M.Coetzee is born in 9th February 1940. He was born in South Africa. He was known as a novelist, essayist, translator. Achieved Nobel Prize in 2003 in literature. So let's start the novel with the basic information. This novel originally published in 1986. This novel is retelling Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe. Let's see the structure of the novel. This novel is divided into four parts. Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3, and Chapter 4. In first chapter, described Barton's speech. In second chapter, described writing letters to Poe. In chapter 3, described Barton going to join Poe. In fourth chapter, described Poe's ethic to alive into the sea breath. Now we can discuss the character of the novel. Susan Barton, Friday, Crusoe, and Poe, and Amy, Susan Junior, and Jeff. These are the main character in the novel. These are major character in the novel, and these are minor character. Here we have talked about the themes of the novel. The themes is female experience, slavery. Next thing is slavery. The next is storytelling. The next is language. The next is primitivism. And the next is humanitarianism. Main theme in this novel is colonialism and decolonialism. And decolonization. decolonization. Coetzee used this theme in his many works. So let's we can see Coetzee used this theme in his most famous work, Dustland. And then he used this theme in Waiting for Barbarians. Waiting for Barbarians is Foe's most famous works, and in this novel he is used ethnocentric term.
That
his most recent work is the master of Petersburg. Petersburg and Foe. In Waiting for Barbarians, used the color term. In this work, described colonialism, before colonialism. Let's we have talk about the symbol of the novel. The first symbol is the tongue, and the second is the Iceland. The tongue is the one of the strongest symbol in the novel, and representing power of speech. Coetzee's novel doesn't work in the way that it works in Defoe's novel as an idealized space, if not a utopia side. Utopia outside of civilization and human society. After watching this video, friends, you are eligible to give an online quiz. So please, you all appear in the quiz. I have given quiz link in my YouTube video's description. So please check it. Best of luck for the quiz. Once again, happy Teachers Day, friends, and thank you so much for watching my video.